Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this solved exercise, we are going to calculate the acceleration of a box moving under the action of a pushing force and a friction force. Calculate the distance traveled by the box during the time interval 0, 1 second. Calculate the acceleration of the box after removing the pushing force. Calculate the time needed by the box to stop.
Fadi pushes a wooden box B of mass M equal 40 kilograms by applying a horizontal force F of magnitude 140 newtons. The box starts from rest at time 0 and moves along a horizontal track. The friction force acting on B has a magnitude of 120 newtons and has a direction opposite to that of the motion of B, neglect air resistance. Number 1. Name and represent not to scale the forces acting on the box. The system is the box. The external forces acting on the box are the weight mg, which acts vertically downwards, the normal force n, which acts vertically upwards, the force f, which acts in the direction of the motion, and the friction force opposite to the direction of the motion.
Let's move to part 2. Apply Newton's second law to determine the magnitude of the acceleration of B. Let's use Newton's second law to determine the magnitude of the acceleration. As we have seen in the previous slide, we have four forces acting on the box. The sum of these forces equals the mass times the acceleration. Now, let's project the vectors along the x-axis. Let's start with force F. Force F is in the positive x direction as shown in the figure. So it doesn't have a component along the y-axis. Then the projection of F along the x-axis is F. Let's move to the friction force. The friction force is in the negative x direction. So here we have minus F. The weight is perpendicular to the x-axis, so it doesn't have a component along this axis. Then we have zero. The normal force also is perpendicular to the x-axis, and then we have zero. Now, rearrange. So we have A equals F minus F over M. F equals 140 newtons, the friction is 120 newtons, and the mass is 40 kilograms. Therefore, the acceleration equals 0.5 meters per second squared.
Number 3. Deduce the nature of motion of the box. In the previous slide, we proved that the acceleration of the box is constant and is equal to 0.5 meters per second squared. We know that in rectilinear motion with constant acceleration, if A times V is greater than 0, then the motion is uniformly accelerated rectilinear. And if A times V is less than 0, the motion is uniformly decelerated rectilinear. In our example, V is greater than 0 since the box moves along the positive x direction. And A is also positive, then A times V is greater than 0. Therefore, the motion is uniformly accelerated rectilinear.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 4.1. Calculate the speed of the box at time 1 second. As we have seen in the previous slide, this is a rectilinear motion with constant acceleration. Here we have the three basic equations of this motion. Which equation would we choose to calculate the speed at time 1 second? Look at the first equation. It includes t and v. Then let's use this equation. The acceleration is 0.5 meters per second squared, and the time is 1 second. The initial speed is zero, and then the speed at time 1 second equals 0.5 meters per second. Part 4.2. Calculate the distance traveled by the box during the time interval 0.1 second. If you want to calculate the distance, so you cannot use the first equation. We can use the second and the third equation. Let's start with the second equation. Now take x0 to the left side of the equation. You will get x minus x0. We are moving in the positive sense. Then x minus x0 equals the distance traveled by the box. Then we have d equals 1 half a t squared plus v 0 t. Now let's calculate the distance. The acceleration is 0.5 meters per second squared. The time is 1 second. The initial speed is zero. Therefore, the distance is 0.25 meters. Let's use the third equation. Now, the speed at time 1 second is 0.5 meters per second. The acceleration is 0.5 meters per second squared, and the initial speed is zero. Then the distance is 0.25 meters.
At time 3 seconds, Fadi lets go of the box. 5.1. Determine the acceleration of the motion of the box, applying Newton's second law. In this case, or after the time 3 seconds, there is no force exerted by Fadi on the box, so we still have three external forces, the friction, the weight, and the normal force, projecting these vectors along the x-axis gives. As we have seen in the previous slide, the projection of the friction is minus F, the projection of the weight is zero, and the projection of N is also zero. Rearrange, we get A equals minus F over M. Replace F by 120 and replace M by 40. Therefore, A equals minus 3 meters per second squared.
Let's move to part 5.2. Determine the time needed by the box to stop. Before calculating this time, let's calculate the value of the velocity at time 3 seconds before letting go of the box. We will use this equation. The initial velocity before letting go of the box is 0. The acceleration is 0.5 meters per second squared. And we want to calculate V at time 3 seconds. Then V at time 3 seconds is 1.5 meters per second. Now let's calculate the time needed by the box to stop. We will use the same equation. After letting go of the box, V0 equals 1.5 meters per second because the velocity at time 3 seconds before letting go of the box is equal to the initial velocity, or the velocity at time 0 after letting go of the box. Also, after letting go of the box, the acceleration is minus 3 meters per second squared, and we want to calculate the time needed by the box to stop, then V equals 0. This time equals 0.5 seconds, and this time is counted after letting go of the box.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share!